Hey guys, Aaron here. So, doing another fanfiction from Exabyte, and this one is BYTE's 5, The New Face of Playtime. Alright. A pile of wires and robot junk, said my friend Jack, describing a new character to Freddy Fazbear's Pizza. Really? The posters show Funtime Foxy has a cool new addition, I exclaimed, disappointed. Apparently, Freddy's added a new character named Funtime Foxy. And my best friend Jack went with his family yesterday and promised to tell me what he looked like. Lies. It was a huge pile of trash. Barely resembles a fox. Only a head. Oh, by the way, I called Claire before we left yesterday and she confirmed she won't be able to make it to your birthday party next week at Freddy Fazbear's, he said, frowning. Why can't Claire go? She usually makes it every year, I yelled annoyingly. She meant she was going on vacation. That's it, he answered, getting on his bike. Anyway, I got to run. Mom's making deep dish. See you at the party, he said, biking down the street. I waved and walked home. Once I got home, my dad greeted me. Hey, Danny! I was hanging out with Jack. Oh, did Jack describe that new character you were interested in at the new pizza place? Yeah. Said it was a pile of wires and animatronic parts, I answered, throwing my backpack on the couch. May be repaired. Also, is Claire coming? You mentioned you haven't found out yet. No, I said, interrupting. Too bad, Danny. She's going to miss lots of fun, exclaimed Dad, smiling. I nodded, went to my room. I walked to my Katie calendar and made sure enough. And sure enough, it said my birthday was in 3 days. I smiled, circling June 5th with a big red marker. I then walked out and went to eat supper. Mom's going to be late again. She got a late shift at the hospital, said my dad, taking out the chicken breast from the oven. He started cutting it into tiny pieces for me and got me a plate and scooped a few pieces of it onto it. Well, that's fine, I answered, eating my chicken. Yep, being a nurse isn't that calm of an occupation, he said, sitting down in front of me. Where's Nadia? She isn't home yet, I asked, looking outside the window facing the driveway beside the table. She decided to stay tonight in her dorm. She has a lot of studying to do for an exam before she starts back up, he answered, chewing a huge chicken pieces. I see. I said, getting up for a cup of milk and washing my plate. I might bike to Claire's later. Say goodbye to her before she leaves on her trip. Really? Sounds quite fun. Tell Brad and the rest of the family I give good wishes, exclaimed my dad, getting up as well. I nodded and walked outside toward my bike. I biked all the way to Claire's house and rang the doorbell. Surprisingly, Brett and a girl I never seen before answered the door. Hey, Danny, Claire's upstairs playing, he answered, giving his warming smile. Big warming smile. Who's the girl? I asked, winking. Oh, that's Tracy. You haven't met Tracy yet. Well, Tracy, this is Claire's best friend, Danny. Danny, this is my girlfriend, Tracy. Remember the last fanfiction? I shook her hand, then walked inside. I went upstairs to Claire's pink, bright, colorful room. Claire was sitting on her bed, frowning and playing with her dolls. Hey, Claire, what's wrong? I asked, sitting next to her. I wish I could go to your party, but we have to go to stupid grandma's, she screamed, throwing her dolls. I rolled my eyes. She's such a child, I thought, looking into Claire's eyes. You know what, Claire, I actually have to go. My dad needs help. See you later. Have a good trip, I said, walking up downstairs, hanging out at the front door. Bye, Brett. Bye, Tracy, I exclaimed, running outside. By the time I got home, Dad was napping on the couch. I crept into my room, showered, got into my pajamas, and slept till morning. 2 days until the party. When I woke up the next day, Dad was gone, only Nadia was home. Hey, Squirt, shouted Nadia, giving me a big hug. Hey, Nadia, long time no see, I said, hugging her back. Are you coming to my party? I asked, getting some orange juice. Not for the animatronic show, but for the cake part, she said, smiling. Animatronics show? I asked, raising an eyebrow. Oh, that's right, I wasn't supposed to tell you, she answered, covering her mouth. Don't worry, I don't mind. I had to talk to her some more. I went back into my room and called Jack. Hello? He answered, sending word. Hey, Jack, just want to know that I... Shh! He whispered, angry. Why are you shushing me? I asked, annoyed. I'm alone in my house, and someone's here. It's your parent, dummy, I answered, giggling. They just left, he explained, now almost terrified. Oh, I answered. Your brother, maybe? I asked again. No, he's visiting Grandma in Missouri, he answered. All of a sudden, I heard robotic stomping on his side. They're here! Tell no one this happened! Danny, you are the best of friends! Bye, Danny! Then he hung up on me. I called again, but no answer. I was a little worried, but he told me to tell no one, so I won't. I wouldn't let this one ruin me. I bite to his house tomorrow. After lunch, I bite to the little valley behind our house and play there until dinner. It was then I really got worried about Jack. What happened to him? Is he alright? He better be. He's always been there for me. To lose would be unbearable. Unless that's a little clue about Barry killing him, if that's the case. One day until the party. Dad and Mom had to go to Freddy Fazbear's today to talk with the planner at my party. They wanted me to go so I could help customize to my liking. When we go there, a nice girl with blonde hair met us. Hi, I'm Patricia! I'll be your party player here at Freddy Fazbear's Pizza, she exclaimed. Okay, thank you. How do we start? My mom asked while I'm Patricia inside. Sure, the first thing you need to cover is the exact party room you would like. You get a party room 1, 2, 3, or 4. Which is best? Dad asked, tilting his head in wonder. Well, we assign one animatron character each room. It depends on your child's favorite, Patricia said, smiling at me. Number 1 is Toy Freddy, number 2 is Toy Bonnie, number 3 is Toy Chica, and number 4 is Balloon Boy. They all looked at me. I was confused why Mango wouldn't come. I want Mango, I exclaimed, smiling. Sorry, sweetie. He's only in Kid's Cove, but you can choose the others, Patricia answered. Just to let somebody know, Mangle in FNAF 2 was said to be a guy. But in Custom Night, it's Ladies Night, so don't blame me. Okay, I like Chica to come, I said, pointing at Chica performing on stage. Okay, she said, writing on her checkboard. Chica will sing, give you cake, and presents if that's okay, asked Patricia, pointing to the kids drawing at Chica giving cake. Perfect! My parents exclaimed in unison. Awesome. Now, to the more detailed party planning, said Patricia walking down in the hall. Hooray! We only have one day until the greatest birthday party ever. Party day. Dun dun dun. Hey, Danny and family, yelled Patricia running over. So, to help oversee Chica while she performs, my friend Harold Knight, remember him, is going to come introduce her and help out. Is that okay? Sure, answered my parents, nodding in agreement. Okay, perfect. So all we need is Danny to go and have fun, said Patricia, pointing to the arcade games. I ran up with my friends and played some games. I got to get Balloon Boy's balloon for free, and Bonnie played his own song for me. When we got to the party room, that Harold Knight came and said, Hello, and thank you for choosing Freddy Fazbear's to celebrate the very special day. For our special young man, we have called the party girl herself to come and visit. Everyone welcome Chica. Hey, I'm getting some flashbacks here. And she came in, we all went wild. I was a little upset because he called me a man. Because I was a girl. But that was okay. After she gave cake, sang a song, gave me presents, she and Harold left. Then the parents left. My friends got confused. Then a golden rabbit came inside. Might want to work on that word, Cade. It's came, not can, but okay. Hey, kids, let's have some fun and celebrate, it said, pulling on knife. We screamed and I hid under the table. Isn't this fun? It exclaimed, stabbing my friend Elaine. It's gonna murder us! I exclaimed, starting to cry. Time for party, it said, stabbing another friend of mine named Marcus. No! I exclaimed. I ran out of the table, banged on the door. I banged louder. I started wailing. No one can take you from the fun, cupcake, it said, stabbing another party member. Mom! Dad! Nana! Help me! I screamed, banging the door even louder. Time for your friends to join in the fun, exclaimed, stabbing another kid. Now it was only me. The rabbit came closer. Save my eyes. Happy birthday, it said, raising his knife. I cried, knowing I was alone, about to die. Suddenly, outside the door, Mango showed his face. Suddenly knocking the door and waving. I waved back and made my last smile. That's when I saw the blade knife aiming for my heart. Oh. Artist note, 5 stories? Well, that's insane. We're already halfway done with the series. Well, Aaron, are you confused with the timeline? Not really, to be honest. No offense. I actually see some connections. I bet you are, but also you must be happy knowing you start to prove your theory about Danny's death. But there's still some unanswered questions. Who is Jack? And who is Patricia? Are they important to the timeline? I'm sure Aaron will try to answer the best possible. That's her bits night number 6. Here's your teaser. There's no place like home. The story is a mix of FNAF 4 and FNAF 2, so I hope you enjoy this, and the stories will keep coming until the finale. Loves and hugs, Exabyte. guys, this story connected back to the first book in the two-parter I did in the first two fan fictions, well, math fan fiction I wrote. So that's a connection. So we just got more of a detailed version from a child's perspective. And that connects with, of course, now we know the end, how the friends died. But Jack, I think what happened to Jack was the same way happened to Tracy, well, almost. An animatronic was at his house and killed him. And Tracy was lucky to escape. But who's an animatronic? I have no idea. It must be one of the nightmare animatronics. Maybe Nightmare Freddy or something. Since he said unbearable in there. But anyway, guys, if you guys enjoy, please give it a thumbs up. This is a very emotional story. Gosh darn it. Cade, you're getting better in writing, but you're also getting a little darker, like the FNAF lore. So anyway, enjoy the rest of this video when you watch it. Anyway, I'm signing out. God bless. You rock. Don't forget it.